Inmates at our jails and the men and women guarding them are engaged in a non-stop cat-and-mouse battle of wits. There's the constant threat of smuggled contraband, particularly phones and drugs. Nine's crime reporter Emma Partridge was given exclusive access as police carried out a raid in Sydney's northwest.
For every tricky crook...
Inmates are very inventive.
There's a clever crime buster whose job is tracking down the phones, move between jail cells and finding the drugs smuggled into prisoners, sometimes sent by drone delivery. We were there for the briefing.
The search operation will target inmates.
As special operations officers from corrective services prepared for wall-to-wall search. At the John Moroney complex near Windsor, a dozen officers and two eager dogs, tails wagging, but all business. Officers were reacting to a tip-off.
We have various methods of collating that and collecting that intelligence.
The raid is swift and relentless. Every corner of the cells searched and sniffed.
This cell block's only been operational for a few weeks, but prison officers have intelligence to suggest that inmates are already trying to smuggle in drugs and mobile phones.
Last year, the crack team dedicated to carrying out the raids did more than 135,000 searches of inmates, visitors and centres, resulting in 163 charges against inmates and 251 against visitors. It's not always peaceful. Prisoners can react badly to the raids. Officers attacked.
I have seen bites, broken bones, broken jaws.
They now have body-worn cameras.
We're just trying to provide them with that extra assurance that if they are assaulted or if they do have a use of force, it can be recorded correctly and the offenders can be charged.
But it's mostly a battle of wits that goes on and on. Emma Partridge, Nine News.